Today, we will discuss about performance based assessment, and within that, we will see portfolio assessment, rubrics, reflective journals, and authentic assessment. This topic we will see, and in this, we will see that what is performance based assessment. We will try to define. Then how it is different from the product-based assessment, and we will see that what are the merit of a performance-based assessment, so that we are talking about to implement performance-based assessment and process-based assessment, like that we will see. And we will also see the different modality of implementing performance-based assessment. So when we talk about the assessment, broadly it can be categorized as the performance-based assessment and the product-based assessment. So in the product-based assessment, we are assessing the learning achievement of the learner, of the student, at the end of the learning process. At the end of learning process is not necessarily at the end of a semester or at the end of an academic year. At the end of learning means that when the learning process of one concept will be over. For sake of example, suppose that we are teaching about the magnetism in class 9. So when the magnetism will, this whole teaching of a concept of a magnetism will get over, then we will have a assessment of the learning, what you have learned. And typically in the product-based assessment, we used to assess through the paper pencil test or the conventional methods of assessment. That is the happening in the product-based assessment. However, when we talk about the performance-based assessment, here in the performance-based assessment, a student requires to demonstrate their knowledge, skill and strategy by creating a response or a product. Here in this assessment method, they are supposed to produce skill, knowledge, strategy by creating a response or a product. Means they may come up with a model, they may come up with a writing, they may come up with a findings. So rather than having a product assessment in the earlier case by using paper pencil test or any conventional methods of testing, here the students are supposed to produce, supposed to exhibit, supposed to demonstrate about their knowledge, about their skill and the strategies that are emphasized here. And this type of assessment continues throughout the learning process. It is not like that when the learning will happen, one concept will be taught, like that in the earlier case I was talking, that if we are teaching about the magnetism, and when the teaching of a concept of a magnetism will get over, then the assessment will be done. No. Here in this case, assessment will go throughout the process, and that's why it is are different from the conventional standardized test, wherein students are supposed to perform a task or generate their responses in the structured way. For example, you may take that in a performance task, a writing may be required by the student to actually produce a piece of writing rather than answering a series of questions. Like that, how to do? Like that, in the conventional method of assessment, after teaching, we are giving a set of questions and they are supposed to respond those questions. But here, in the case of performance assessment, they may be required to write their feelings. They may be required to illustrate the process of their learning. They may be required to transcribe the kind of process they have adapted to learn. So in that way, it is a different from the conventional method of assessment. Here, the knowledge, skill, and strategy demonstration is important rather than answering a series of questions. And it will be done throughout the learning process, not at the end of learning process. Then come to the merit. What are the merit of this type of assessment? Performance-based assessment. The performance-based assessment are said to be assessment of next generation. Next generation means that it can cater the need of the coming time. In the coming time, we require a person with a creative thinking, critical thinking, skills, knowledge, together with the problem solving skills. These type of things are required for the coming time. So, if any testing method, any assessment method can cater these type of thing, then we can say that yes, it is catering the need of a coming generation. First thing that we will see that performance-based assessment is the assessment in the real world. Assessment in the real world means here the assessment is happening in the real time. When the students are learning. So that you can identify what kind of a problem the students are facing. Simultaneously, you can also identify what kind of strength they are having, how they are learning, how they are working, how they are participating, how they are exhibiting, how they are solving a problem, so that you can understand. So, this is the assessment in the real world because it is happening simultaneously when you are doing the teaching learning process, when the learning is happening.
Yes, sir.
So, it is the assessment in the real world. Then, the second merit of this performance-based assessment is that it is the authentic one. Why it is the authentic one? Because here we are assessing the learner in the real setup. It is not a artificial setup. Real setup means here the students are working, they are performing, they are exhibiting, they are experimenting, they are working together. So the real dynamics can be tapped. You can tap here the real thing. In the conventional method of assessment, there is a problem that a student may have memorized it, rote memory without understanding, and they have reproduced. So on the basis of a writing, you can give a mark, but that will not be authentic. Why? Because this is the memorized one without understanding the concept. Here, that type of incident does not come. Here, they are supposed to participate in the assessment when they are learning. So they will be observed in the real setup. And once it will be observed in a real setup, we can say that it is the authentic one. And the next one is that it promotes the higher order thinking process. Higher order thinking process means it promotes the thinking skill, the skill of drawing conclusion through, it may be using the deductive or inductive reasoning, skill of synthesizing information, skill of analysis, skill of problem solving, skill of creativity in performing the work. Because you are observing and you are doing in a real setup. So all these things, tapping all those things are possible. But when you will be assessing in the conventional method through a paper pencil test, all those things may not be possible. Even beyond the higher order thinking, the socio-emotional abilities can be tapped. How much you are a emotionally balanced one? How much you are having a social skill to get the work done? How much you have a social skill of talking with each other? So this type of a socio-emotional skill can also be tapped. That are not possible to tap in the conventional methods of assessment. That can be assessed here. So it is the authentic method of assessment. It is promoting the higher order thinking process. It is the assessment in the real world. But the thing comes, if it have so much of a benefit, so much of a potential, then how we can implement the performance-based assessment? So there is a modality of performance based assessment, how we can implement. The one of the very important tool in the performance based assessment is the rubrics. We know that the rubric is the performance based assessment criteria. It is the assessment criteria based upon the performance. So in the rubric, we may maintain a different criteria, different label of a performance, and performance indicator we maintain, and it is linked with the achievement score. I will say why it is required, how it is. For sake of example, you just consider, in order to perform performance-based assessment, you are observing the student who are working in a natural setup, or you are observing the student who are studying in the classroom, are experimenting, are debating, discussing, exhibiting. But the problem comes, how you will assess their act. In the paper pencil test, there is a response to a question. That question is this. This is supposed to write in the answer. And what is written? So based upon that, you can mark the answer. But here, there is no structured type of a thing. So first we need to structure it. And in order to structure, we used to make a rubrics. Performance-based assessment criteria. We can understand this with an example. For sake of example, a student is doing an activity to illustrate some scientific concept. For sake of example, again we can take the example of calculating a value of or calculating a perimeter, for example, perimeter of any geographical, geometrical object. Perimeter of any geometrical object. This is the problem is given to the child. So, in order to assess them through a portfolio, we can make a criteria. First criteria, suppose that if it is a 5-mark question, so first criteria may be that whether the student have identified the measure of all side of that geometrical figure or not. If they have identified all measure of all sides of a geometrical figure, then 1 mark. Then the student have adapted a appropriate formula or not. Then the next 2nd mark. Then if it is required to convert the different type of measuring unit in 1 unit. Suppose that one side is given in a meter, other side is given in the centimeter. So, it needs to be converted in a single unit. So, it is converted in a single unit or not, then a 3rd mark. Then, after calculating the result, the answer is written in an appropriate format or not, then the 4th mark. And the 5th mark can be the calculation accuracy. So, if the calculation is accurate, then we can give a 5 mark. So, that was an example of a rubric for simple problem. The rubric can be used for when the student are exhibiting, performing. For example, you can think that student have been sent for a group work to collect the information on the biodiversity existing in their neighborhood. Biodiversity. So, how it can be? one mark we can give for, suppose that it is again of a 5 point. So one mark we may give that selecting the appropriate place. One mark we may give that documentation. So if they have selected, one mark they will get. If it is a documented well, then again one mark they will get. Team dynamics, then again one mark they will get. Accepting leadership, because one person, one student may be a leader. So again one mark they will get. Presentation, how it is presented, then again one mark they get. Then the logical arrangement, then again one mark they will get. Like that, the milestones. If you have performed up to here, then you will get this mark. So rubric is a performance based assessment criteria. Because when we are observing, when we are documenting their exhibitions, their talk, their group work, we need a assessment criteria that how they will be assessed. And especially when we talk about the performance based assessment, then rubric is one of the important tool that must be developed well before the assessment. That is the performance based assessment criteria. Then second thing is how to implement the rubric. We have seen that what is the rubric, what are the different modality. In order to implement rubric, the rubric must be prepared well before assigning the work, so that the different parameter will be well defined. And if it is a well defined, then you can set the parameters and you can assign the weightage. It is, for example, I have only explained that one mark you can give, but it is not necessarily. Some work which have a higher weightage, for them you can give a more weightage. So it must be developed well before starting the performance based assessment. Then the next one is the portfolio assessment. This is also very useful and very innovative tool for having a performance based assessment. Portfolio is the collective record of the student artifacts, student's performance over the time period. It is a collection about the student's performance over the time period with the evidence. How with the evidence? Suppose that you have given a test, it may be conventional test, or you have observed, and your observation you may write separately in a folder assigned to each individual student. So suppose that the 30 students are there in a class, so 30 folder will be there. You will maintain their performance, whether they are participating in a curricular or a co-curricular work, you will be documenting their performance in the test, their performance in the game and sport, their performance in the classroom talk, their performance in the experimental session when they are exhibiting everything that will be documented. And when it will be documented and when this document will be ready, it will be actually an illustrative picture of student performance over the time period. Student performance, not product. Student performance, how much he was attentive, how much he was a regular, what kind of a dynamics he was having with the peer member, with the teachers, with the school staff, regularity, punctuality, cleanliness, everything can be documented. And at the end of the assessment period, you can have a clear-cut picture about how the student have performed over a time period. And with this picture, you can assess the students easily. Portfolios are also of a variety of a type based upon the mediums that we are using, like a digital portfolio, e-portfolio, online portfolio, and for a purpose also there is a different type of a portfolio, like a process portfolio, like a product portfolio. Product portfolio is for the showcase. Suppose that you know you have so many skills, then you will prepare a portfolio for a purpose of showcasing your skill. Basically, we used to have for a getting a better employment opportunity. Like that, we used to make a resume. That is also a one kind of a portfolio, because in the resume you are giving your personal detail. And then you are showing your achievement and educational qualification. So achievement and educational qualification is nothing but it is the anecdote of a success to praise the employer to give you a suitable job. So that is also one kind of a portfolio. Another kind of a portfolio is a process-based portfolio, which is prepared when the process is going on. Like that, the assessment portfolio that we will prepare, it will be the process portfolio. And the resume that we used to make for an employment opportunity, that may be a product or the showcase portfolio. And here teacher are supposed to maintain the anecdote of each individual. It not only helps in doing the authentic assessment. Yes, it is authentic because it is based upon the real performance of a child. But it also helps when that student goes to next grade. Suppose that the student was in the fifth grade. He completed the fifth grade and went to the sixth grade. So the teacher of a sixth grade can estimate the performance of a child by seeing his or her previous portfolio. So that is the also one of the modality, isn't it? Then the next tool in this series for assuring performance based assessment is the reflective journals. Journals are nothing but it's a logbook. Logbook means it's a kind of a diary wherein you are maintaining a record of everything that you are doing, you done, you did, how you did, what kind of a hurdle you faced, what kind of opportunity you faced, so that you can reflect on your work, and when you will be doing the same and a similar thing in the future, you can get a reflection from your previous work to do that in a better manner. Suppose that I am now learning geometry. Within the geometry, I am studying about the quadrilaterals. I may write what you have learned, how you have learned, what kind of a difficulty you faced, and in order to overcome out of those difficulty, how you will act in the future. So that when you will learn three-dimensional objects, you can have a reflection out of your previous learning to perform it better. So, the reflective diary is the logbook of anecdotes. It's a kind of a diary. It's a kind of a journal writing, logbook writing. And based upon, and then comes, okay, if I will write those things, then it will help me to improve myself. Yes, okay. Then how it will help for assessment purpose? Because by seeing those log entries, anyone can easily identify that how you are progressing. Remember always, in the educational setup, attainment is not more important. Progress is important. Progress is important, not attainment. You can understand in this way. For sake of example, there are two students. One student is A, another student is B. So the entry label, suppose that the attainment, suppose that I have taken a test of 100 mark, and this A is securing 70 mark. And this B is securing 60 mark. And after educational intervention, this A is securing 75 mark. And B is securing 70 marks. Then you will find that still the achievement score of A is more than that of B. Yes, A has more score than that of B. But when we talk about the progress in a performance, then B have performed better than the A, because here the increase in performance is only 5. Here is in increase in performance is 10. So the performance of B is better than that of A. However, the mark is more. A is having more mark. But when we talk about the performance, B is better. So when we will maintain the logbook, we can also have a track record on the learning improvement. And since it will be documented, and when you will revisit that, not only for the teacher but for the student also, it will motivate them that I was this, I worked that much, then I progressed up to here. So how much they have to work. So in that way, the reflective journals are also very much important. And altogether, these performance-based assessment promotes the authentic modality of assessment. They are authentic because they are in the real setup. For the reflective diary, it is in the real setup. You have to write. without mentioning the name of the student so that the teacher cannot pinpoint. Then the rubric, it is based upon the performance, it is authentic. Portfolio, it is the collection of artifacts, it is authentic. So these are the way by which we can assure the implementation of performance based assessment. So this was all about the performance based assessment and the different key features of performance based assessment and the modality of assuring performance based assessment. Now it is a time for question answer session. So if you have any doubt or a question, anything, you may ask now.
Hello sir.
हाँ प्रियंका बोलिए.
परफॉर्मेंस बेस्ड असेसमेंट हम सोशल साइंस सब्जेक्ट में कैसे करेंगे? सोशल साइंस सेकेंड लेवल का सोशल.
सपोज दैट यू वांट टू यूज रूब्रिक एज अ परफॉर्मेंस बेस्ड असेसमेंट टूल एंड वन टॉपिक दैट आई एम टेकिंग. टू टॉपिक हम लेंगे साइमल्टेनियसली. मैथ और साइंस का मैंने दे दिया है, सो दैट इज ओवर. सो अगेन वन टॉपिक आई विल टेक फ्रॉम one topic I will take from the language and one topic I will take from social science mein se kiska le, history, geography. Suppose that history ka ek topic le lete hain, theek hai. So two topic lenge. So suppose that in the history we are modern history mein hum dekh rahe hain, padh rahe hain, ya aur medieval mein bhi dekh sakte. मुगल पीरियड्स के बारे में हम लोग पढ़ रहे हैं, है ना, किसी का डायनेस्टी के बारे में, और सपोज दैट कि इंडियन फ्रीडम मूवमेंट के बारे में पढ़ रहे हैं इन द हिस्ट्री. और इन द लैंग्वेज वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट सम पोएट्री रिटन बाय द शेक्सपियर, है ना. सो इसके लिए हाउ वी कैन प्रिपेयर अ रूब्रिक. सो फर्स्ट वी विल सी द poetry. Here in the poetry you may make criteria. That one criteria is that student is able to recite in a rhythm, and because the recitation of a poem is also one of the skill in the language learning. So whether the student is able to recite the poem. So, उसके लिए एक वन माइल स्टोन हो सकता है. देन द सेकेंड माइल स्टोन में भी दैट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द ब्रीफ लाइफ स्केच ऑफ द पोएट. बिकॉज वेन यू विल सी द राइटर एंड द राइट अप यू विल फाइंड देयर इज अ कॉरिलेशन. व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ राइटिंग अ राइटर इज राइटिंग इट इज लिंक्ड विद देयर एक्सपीरियंस देयर लाइफ. So you know or not. Then this will be the second milestone. Third milestone may be that you know the meaning of some of the difficult word used in the poem, है ना, keywords का meaning आपको पता है यानी. Then the next may be whether you can explain the meaning of the poem your own word or not. So that may be another milestone. Then linking the higher order mein jaate hain, linking the meaning and the essence of a poem to a present situation, that may be another milestone. If it is a writing, then you can also see the if it is a they are speaking, then you can may have one milestone for the phonetics, proper pronunciation. If it is the writing, then the proper word structure and as per the label of a study. Now come to the another example, like that I was talking about the Indian freedom movement. So here you may have one milestone, identification of the different leaders of Indian freedom movement. Kaun-kaun different leaders the. Then identification of a different groups in the Indian freedom movement, because all were not belonging from the same group. Gandhiji had one, another group, Subhash Chandra Bose had another group, Bhagat Singh. They had a philosophical differences also. Naram Dal and Garam Dal, like that we used to study. Then the effort made by those, if are able to illustrate. ऐसे करके नाउ यू कैन हैव अ डिफरेंट माइलस्टोन इन द सोसाइटीज. इफ इट इज अ राइटिंग देन यू कैन सिक्वेंशियल फ्लो प्रॉपर एग्जाम्पल्स एग्जाम्पलीफिकेशन एक्यूरेसी ऑफ द एनेक्डोट्स है ना, दिस कैन बी द माइलस्टोन इन द प्रोग्राम.